We get lots of letters, and a lot of them ask about the science behind daredevil stunts, like this one from Stephen Kelly of Atlanta, Georgia, who writes, "How can stunt people survive lying on a bed of nails? Sometimes they even have bricks smashed on their chests. How is this possible?" Good question. And we have just the right man to provide the answer. He's Jack Netland, high school physics teacher from Osseo, Minnesota. Jack, how can these people survive lying on a bed of nails?
Well, there's one word for it, Ira, and that word is physics.
Physics. Every time you come on the show and I ask you a question, you say the answer is physics.
Well, it's my favorite word. I don't know, Ira. Anyway, I brought with me a sort of perfect sleeper here to help, and I thought you might lie on there. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you want me to lie on this bed of nails.
Yes. Would you lie down on there, please?
No, thank you, Jack. You lie on the bed of nails. I'm not going on there.
I was afraid you're going to say that. But anything for physics,
you're
okay?
You're going to get on here? This looks like they're sharp.
Well, they are sharp. You want to see how sharp they are? I'll show you sharp.
Gee.
I'll take the nail, the Newton's apple here. Drop it on the nail, and there you are. Yes,
whoa.
They really are.
I couldn't
on
even
there.
Get it out of it, and it's applesauce.
Yes, indeed. Well, we don't need that anymore. It's gone.
It's gone.
Okay, I'm going to take and lie down on this bed of nails now,
right.
And I'm going to have you take a concrete block and break it on my stomach, okay?
Wait. You want me to take a concrete block?
Sure.
Well, aren't you going to hurt yourself?
Hey, would I do that on purpose, Ira? No.
Oh, look at that.
I'm not going to hurt myself. There we go. On the nails. Nice and comfy.
You all right?
I'm fine. Get the concrete block now.
You want me to put this concrete block on you?
You bet.
I hope you're insured, Jack.
I sure am.
How come you're not being hurt very badly here by these nails?
Well, there's about 500 nails there, Ira, and so my weight is distributed amongst them, and so on any one nail, there's not that much. Of course, if I tried this on one nail, I'd probably leak a little bit.
You'd leak a lot.
Yeah, I would. Now, give me the goggles so I can protect my eyes.
All right.
And then if you put goggles over your eyes, then take the hammer and break the concrete block on my stomach. Okay.
You're going to be all right. I'm going to hit this real hard, you know.
You bet. Go ahead. Hard
right.
as you want.
Okay.
Okay, go ahead.
You're the boss.
Here we go. Yes, sir.
One more time.
Oh, whoa. I love it. Yeah, break that block. That's all there is to it.
Whoa, are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. Yep, I'm fine.
Oh. Let me see your back. Back looks fine.
Oh, yeah.
No little holes in it anywhere.
No, I don't think so.
You're okay. You really are okay.
How come
I was able to do that?
I had something helping me there, and the thing that was helping me was the thing we call inertia.
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 How is this thing called inertia helping you?
Let's see if we can describe that a little bit. Why don't we go over to the other concrete block we've got hanging here?
All right.
This is exactly the same as the one you ruined here on my stomach. And Newton's law, you see, says that something which is at rest tends to stay at rest.
That's inertia.
It also says that something which is in motion tends to stay in motion.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now, this concrete block has that stuff we call inertia or mass.
Or mass.
And I want you then to take this hammer and smack that block good and hard, okay?
All right.
Yes, okay.
Ooh.
It hardly moves.
Hardly moves.
Yeah.
That's because it's very massive.
That's right.
And you say it likes to stay at rest because it has a lot of mass.
Exactly.
And so when this was on your stomach and I hit it with the hammer, it didn't go anywhere because it liked
to
stay there.
Rather than go, it will break instead.
Instead of driving those nails through your back.
Yes, indeed. Oh. So I was not harmed. I was not harmed at all by hitting that block on my stomach.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we've got another block over here, Ira. And I'd like you to take now this looks the same as this one over here. It's gray and it's got the same shape and it's the same size, but it is different.
Yeah.
I want you to go ahead and hit that one, okay? There.
Whoa,
okay.
Whoa, come back. This isn't a block. This is
that's
styrofoam.
A block. Yeah, it is. It's styrofoam.
You fooled me, Jack.
Yes, indeed. It has a whole lot less mass.
So it went very far. I mean, it just didn't want to stay here when I hit it. It just wanted to go flying off.
It doesn't have that as much of that property that we call mass.
So if I put a block that wasn't very massive on your stomach and hit it like I did before, you could be hurt.
Exactly. I could be, yes.
And a lot of people would say this is not, you know, the only difference between these two is this weighs a lot less than
block. That's true, but weight is different than mass.
Weight is different.
It is different. Now, I have a car here that I'd like to show you. Okay, I've got a 56 Olds mobile here.
Car.
No. I just have a 56 Olds.
I've heard of compact cars. I'd say there's a compact.
We're talking super compact.
It's a real compact. Whole car in there.
A whole car body in this little package. Yeah. Now, I want you to go ahead and lift that now, okay?
Well, how much does this weigh?
It's about 1,500 pounds.
Right, you expect me to lift this car.
Yes, you can do that.
Sure, twice on Sunday.
Yeah, maybe so. I'm going to put it up now on a kind of a cushion of air underneath it so that it's free to float.
It's just floating around.
Easily moving
and
now.
Can,
go ahead.
Now
move
I can,
it toward
I can
me.
Push it very easily.
Very easily. It'll come over here to me and I can stop it and turn around and push it back.
Whoa.
Even though you couldn't lift it before.
Whoa, it's very hard to stop it.
Yes, it is.
That's the mass we're talking about.
Exactly.
Huh?
That is the mass, the property of mass. Once it's moving, it wants to stay moving.
And once it stops here, it takes a nice little push.
To move it.
To move. And if we were in space, that's why things, even though they're weightless, they still take a little effort to get moving.
Yes.
And an effort to stop them.
Yes.
That's the mass that it has.
That is the mass that you're dealing with there.
So even if we could put this on your stomach
on the bit of nails.
The weight didn't kill you.
Yeah, it didn't.
The weight didn't kill you. I could hit it with something and this isn't going anywhere.
Exactly, because it is very, very massive. Hmm. Very massive.
Very, very interesting. Is there anything around us every day that we can see how mass is being used all over?
Sure. Well, not every day, but certainly every Sunday afternoon in the fall.
Every Sunday afternoon?
Yeah. Hmm. Let me show you what I mean.
I want to hear about
this. Okay.
I'm beginning to understand.
Yes. This is Leo Lewis from the Minnesota Vikings.
Nice to meet you.
How you doing?
Leo. Thanks for coming.
And Leo is a wide receiver for the Vikings, and he wants to accelerate out there and get down just as fast as he can.
And score.
And score. That's
so
the idea.
So he wants to be maneuverable, right?
Right. Now, he weighs about 182 pounds, which is not a large amount of mass. Mm-hmm. You know, it's not,
compared to what?
Well, relative to Tim Irwin here. Now,
I'm going to fall over.
Tim is an offensive tackle for the Minnesota Vikings.
He weighs over 310 with his equipment on.
Yeah, and that's a lot of mass, more mass than Leo.
You said it. And he wants to be very massive because you want to...
I want to hold my ground.
Wants to hold his ground, and the more massive he is, the tougher it is for somebody to move him.
To move him out of there. Mm. And that's about the size of it.
Thank you very much, Tim. Thank you very
You're
much,
welcome.
Leo. Thank you very much, Jack. We'll move en masse ourselves to the next part of the show in just a minute.